Hey, in this video I'm going to explain you about how to remove T1 noise and offset noise. So for example, here I recorded this HSKC spectra, so in methanol, but when I did the water separation, so there is a noise, this water separation peak, this offset noise. So it's if you want to present whole spectra in any publications, or if you want to show in any conference, so this is not good. So if you want to suppress this offset peak, so without doing experiment also you can suppress. So for that you have to change some processing parameters. So here is the option in process. So here is a BC mode, it's a fit baseline mode for EM, FT or XFB, anything. So this PC mode and BCFW, so these two you have to set up. So BC mode, now it's a quad, put set up as a Q fill, and the BC mode is 1 ppm. So this one is Q fill, is it will suppress that peak, and this BCFW you have to set up this, like how much width you want to decrease. So now okay, I will give 0.1 hertz, 0.1 ppm, and I will go to spectrum. I will give process the spectrum using XFB. It's not suppressed completely. Then I will increase again. 0.5 I will give. See, now it's suppressed completely that T1 noise. So after doing experiment also we can suppress the that not T1 noise, that offset noise, the noise below the suppressed peak. So we can do this. Another example for this is like, here is a toxic, see this, this is suppressed badly, so because of shimming also you will get this noise below the water peak. If it is bad shimming, so it will not suppress properly, so you will get this peak. So again, same thing you can do for this also. So I want to suppress this noise, so go to process. Here instead of BC mode, instead of quad, you can set up Q fill, and here 1 ppm is there, so just set up 0.5. so just you have to vary this width, means it will select how much width it has to suppress from here to here. So I set up the 0.5, and now I will give command XFB. See, now it's suppressed like ABS, so ABS 1. See, now there is no noise along the below the water peak, so it's suppressed completely. So if you increase more, again it will suppress more. See how much width if you give, it will suppress. Like I give 0.5, now I will give around 6. Let's see what will happen. Okay, in process quad 0.5, okay, I will give 4 hertz, 4 ppm. See, when I give 4 ppm it suppressed completely, like all cross peaks also gone. The intensity of this, here it's a peak, it's completely removed. So we are offset, from offset now 4 ppm means this side 2 ppm, left side and right side 2 ppm, it suppressed completely. So you, while using Q fill, we have to be very careful about how much ppm you are going to suppress. So 0.5, now I will give XFP. See this, so this here we are having peaks. So you can easily suppress a noise below the water peak by doing this. And how to suppress this T1 noise, because when you record a cozy, okay, you remove this, when you record a cozy spectrum or any toxic, so we'll have a T1 noise. Here also, see here water peak, it's a toxic, this is, so here also it's a water suppressed, there is a huge noise in the below peak, and also here it's a T1 noise is more. And the same example is like another one is, yeah, this is cozy. See, he has T1 noise so much. So some peaks are overlapping in the noise, are missing in the noise, so you can easily find out. So here also, see this, there are so much noise. So it's very easy to remove here also. So first I will remove this water noise by giving U fill and 0.5 hertz sub B. Yeah, see, I removed this completely, and this water noise. And see here, there are some peaks here in this line, and here there are some peaks, but because of the T1 noise, you are not able to see those peaks. So before using this command, so you have to increase the intensity of the all peaks, so minimum one. So I increase intensity because here I want to check. When you increase, you want to remove the C1, give command sim. It's a symmetric command, so it will symmetrize the spectra, because half diagonal peaks are symmetric compared to here. See, both sides, like on the top and this side, it's a symmetric. So when you symmetric, it will take the intensity of minimum intensity. Like if this is less intense than this, so it will take this intense and it will adjust to, according to this, it will adjust other peaks. So symmetric, when I do symmetric, see here the whole T1 noise is removed, and also I'm getting a peaks of this side and this side, both sides. So for another example is, for this I can give you, yeah, this one. So this one is also, see, so much noise is there, and also so much noise here, some peaks are there in this, so it's very easy to remove. Again, you can use symmetric command, SYM. See, it's removed T1 noise, so it's very easy to now assign the molecule by using this spectra. So if you want to remove this again, you can give xfb command instead of sim. So it's removed now. And for another example is, yeah, this one. So in this, I want to show you again another thing. See, there are when you, before doing symmetric, as I mentioned you, so you have to increase the intensity to see the all peaks, and also it will adjust according to the minimum intense peak. And also see here, this, when I put a cursor, this peak and this peak are correlating, like this peak and this cross peak, it's a mirror image. So this peak intensity is very less, this peak intensity is more. So when I do symmetrize, so here this minimum intense peak is according to this peak, all other peak intensity will organize. So same thing, if I do symmetrize, so same intense peak will come here also. So, and also then noise will reduce. I showed you that noise will reduce, and also I will show you about this peak. See, when I do symmetric, so this peak and this peak intensity will be same. SYM. See this, according to this peak, it's symmetrized, like either this or this, so intensity will change. So now there's also gone, so you can use easily. So by using this symmetric command, you can remove T1 noise, and by using Q fill and some by giving width, you can remove that noise below the water peak. So if you have any doubts about regarding this, you can write me.